when I was thinking about what I wanted to talk about, I turned to the conference theme, and that was learning beyond borders. And in my experience, most of the learning beyond borders that I've done have been finding and overcoming the borders that are in my own mind. So I decided that the talk I would give to you this morning would be about how I became a teacher and why I am still a teacher. Today, there's very little left of the 23-year-old that went to Northern India back in the 80s with the idea that I could make a difference. I was working on an adult health education scheme, and I've gone there starry-eyed and full of dreams about how I was going to make a difference. And the priorities of the women that I've worked with were very different. So they would listen to me as I gave my little talk. They would look at the materials I had to offer them. And then they would invariably ask me a question. And that question was, how can we stop having children? And in fact, that wasn't really the question. The question was, how can we stop having girl children? Because girls were seen as being unlucky. I'd found myself in a sort of twilight zone where women killed both their unborn and living babies because they were poor and they couldn't afford to bring up these girls. And as a young 23-year-old Irish Catholic, this was a very big border that I confronted. And I asked myself, if they don't care about death, what am I doing here teaching them how to stay alive? And was everything I was doing really futile? How could I have compassion for people who didn't value life? Their view of life and death was very different from mine. So I believed we have one life on this earth and we need to live it as long as we can. But for the women I worked with, death was just a door they walked through in order to be reborn into another, hopefully better life. So one day I came right up to that border. I put down my bag of materials in the street, I sat on it, and I wept. And this was quite unusual and shocking behavior. So people stopped what they were doing and looked. And eventually I pulled myself together, wiped the grimy tears off my face and looked up. And I looked up into the eyes of a whole group of children that were standing around staring at me, wondering what was going on. And at that point, it came to me. The women that I'd worked with had had years and years and years of thinking in one way, and I wasn't really going to change anything. The children, however, were very different. They were curious, they wanted to know more. And sitting there in the dirt, in the middle of the street, I made a decision. I made a decision, actually, to turn my back on the women and to return to England and train to be a teacher of children. And 25 years passed. And during that time, I became deeply ashamed of the reason why I became a teacher. I thought how arrogant and superior I was to think my values were more important than those women. All along, it had been me that was wrong. It was me that had lacked empathy for the poverty that influenced their values. And And I was given the opportunity to return to India. And as a different person, I accepted. Now that I'm back in India, I work with adults again. At ASB, we have a teacher training program that runs one Saturday every month, and many of our teachers volunteer in that program. The program lasts for about 2 years. We work with between 70 and 80 teachers who work in extremely challenging conditions. They go out into building sites and try and educate the children of the itinerant building workers. They work in slums with teenagers where they have to round them up and bring them into school. We hope that what we do supports their growth as teachers. In the 4 weeks between each of our sessions, those teachers go back into their schools. They're responsible for training around another 50 teachers before they come back to us again. And each of those 50 teachers teaches around about 80 children in each class. The impact this program is making is huge. So when I moved back to India, I started to learn Hindi, and I learned this word. This word is kal. It means yesterday. It also means tomorrow. And I asked my Hindi teacher, well, how can this same word mean two completely different things? Like, this is crazy. And knowing a little bit of my story, she just smiled at me and she said, Maggie, don't you know that in India, time is circular? And I have come to see that life sometimes gives you the opportunity to do a good thing. And even if you don't take that opportunity, or you can't take it, sometimes life brings you the opportunity again to try and do it. Only if you can step across those borders. And what I've also come to understand is that in a land where time is circular, tomorrow is simply the rebirth of yesterday. Thank you.